Hey, it's Graham, General Manager at BuddyBoss, and I'm here with the highlights from our first quarter of 2025 and a very sneak peek into what's coming up next. In this video, I'll walk you through the big improvements across the BuddyBoss web and app. We'll talk about the revamped product roadmap and how you can help shape it. I'll discuss major updates to our customer support experience, and we'll also address how we're helping you grow a thriving community beyond just launching it. With that said, let's jump in. Throughout 2024, we released features every single month, but this meant we could only really work on smaller features. This year, we're working on some big initiatives to really make huge impacts to your communities and e-learning platforms. Here's what we've launched so far. We're now enabling site administrators to completely disable the counts, which was the number shown at the end of the tab. There were two reasons behind this change. Firstly, this provides a lot more consistency across all tabs, especially when working with third-party integrations. Secondly, calculating the counts on every single page load was causing far more queries than necessary, especially when tabs were not active. So we've now made a conscious effort to move the counts inside of the tab, providing a performance boost, especially for those scaling communities with lots of members, media, or documents. A good number of our communities use followers in addition to connections, but one of the problems is that BuddyBoss platform never came with a dedicated followers page, just a widget. So while you could always see who you were following, you couldn't easily see who followed you. This enhancement now adds a new followers page to the members directory. Look at any modern social network and hover cards are now the standard. Their user experience improvement allowing a simple access to take actions without actually leaving your current page. We've released hover cards taking extra care to pay attention to whether you have specific components enabled, such as connections, followers, send messages, and we're prioritizing them accordingly. Oh, and this also extends to social groups. We've made UI improvements to our activity and group feed filters, making a cleaner approach whilst also adding the ability to now order posts by recent activity. This takes into account comments and bumps those posts to the top of the feed. This is a great improvement if you're finding old posts being actively contributed to. Now in the future, we're going to extend this even further to show relevancy. Think more about trending posts, but with a scoring system for posts, comments, reactions, and also other considerations like if they're a connection or a follower of you. Next up, we have the directory block. Now, it's my vision that app pages can become a page builder for the BuddyBoss app through the use of app blocks, allowing for a fully native applications, but with the combination of fallbacks for maximum compatibility. Now, this new block is just a starting point and a key part of this transition. With the directory block, you'll be able to natively render an archive or listing page for any post type that's been registered with WordPress. If you're using WP Job Manager, you can now have jobs listing directory. If you want to show upcoming events with the events calendar, you can also do this. It's a huge feat for our app team to deliver, and it opens the door to provide a lot more custom blocks, which takes this custom post type capacity to the next level. I should say, it also has no custom development required. And while this enhancement didn't hit the release notes, we've made massive improvements to our build server infrastructure, with app builds now taking less than 10 minutes to build and upload. That is half of the previous time to build. We've also rolled out enhancements to app hooks, social login, LearnDash, WPML, and we've squashed over 100 bugs, with most resolved within 1 to 2 updates. The product roadmap has been a bit of a love-hate relationship over the years. It helps us show the shaping and the vision of our future, but it still needs to be agile when we need to react to changes. Now that could come from customers, integrations, WordPress updates, or just some of our own product decisions. Now we've had 3 evolutions of the roadmap since 2019, and in 2024, we were internally wrestling around the future of the roadmap. The roadmap needs to strike a balance where we can share some insights and collect your feedback, but also needs to be realistic in terms of what we're aiming to achieve. There is nothing worse than an unrealistic roadmap, and that's something that we're prioritizing to resolve. And what about your suggestions? Every year we get thousands of suggestions, and our previous roadmap didn't show those suggestions publicly to you, and this was one of the biggest sticking points that I wanted to change. Well, next week you'll see the new roadmap, and it consists of three sections. We have the product roadmap, which is split by now, next, later. We'll be moving away from specific release dates, but this is going to be a great place to see what we're publicly committing to. And this is also a place where we can get your feedback on the tasks or any specific requirements that you'd like for us to consider. Next, you'll have the feature requests. This is when you can submit and search through over 5,000 existing suggestions. This will be the best place for you to share your thoughts and suggestions, and I highly encourage you to use the search before submitting a duplicate request and potentially splitting the votes. And finally, our release tab will highlight all of the features and enhancements that we've released in time order. Now, in the past, we've neglected to share all of our successes, so you're going to see a lot more of these on a frequent basis. Of course, not everything though will be on the roadmap. We like to keep some surprises, but as a user of BuddyBoss, you're going to get more transparency and input than you've had in the past. Keep an eye out for the email next week and do share your feedback. Until then though, let me give you just a sneak peek into some of the tasks that are already in development. We will be shortly releasing multilingual support to the BuddyBoss app. With this update, you'll be able to translate the app interface into multiple languages, and we're also going to be releasing this feature with pre-translated files. Now, while this does translate the interface, what about the content? Well, that's where WPML comes in. With WPML, we'll be able to translate your content in WordPress pages and any other platform terms. Although, please note, right now, we're not extending this to user-generated content such as activity feeds. At least not yet. I'm really happy that we've managed to team up with WPML to improve our language support, and this is also going to extend into the web, where we start to look at how we can provide a better experience to your communities. We recently sent out a survey looking for feedback, and thank you to everyone who did share their suggestions. But if you didn't see this email, definitely add your comments onto the roadmap card next week. When your users first open their app, they'll now be presented an app overview in a format of slides, which you can show on first launch or first login. This is going to give you a great opportunity to welcome new members and introduce them to the core functionality of your app. With the release of the directory block, we're now going to extend this functionality into more app blocks, such as image and video carousels, with the custom post type support that we've just worked on. Integrations are a huge part of the BuddyBoss ecosystem, and the event calendar is one of the most popular integrations. Communities are about coming together and events. Now, whether that's in person or virtual, they are a vital part of so many thriving communities. And so I'm really happy to share that we're going to be working with the team at Stellar WP to build native support to the events calendar. And for our web customers, I can also confirm they're going to look to enhance their BuddyBoss integration with how it interacts with social groups, which I know has been one of the biggest challenges with every single event plugin available. Now, we are still sharing feedback with their team, but we're basically discussing how events could be associated with groups, how you could have groups have event creation in them, and who can see the groups based on that group membership. Now, if you've got any more suggestions, definitely add it to our roadmap next week. Now that we have activity filters, we still find a need to separate conversations into topics. And this serves as like an alternative to hashtags, which have been in steady decline across many of the social networks through 2024. So soon, you'll be able to actually set activity topics for both the main activity feed, but also in social groups. Now, this allows your users to post under a specific topic, whether that's an introductory post, an announcement, or perhaps for those in the kind of e-learning, it could be split by course lessons or topics, and you'll have the flexibility to filter through those topics in the activity feed. Now, this is one of the biggest changes to BuddyBoss since the release of Theme 2.0. Over the years, we've had many customers who wish to use the BuddyBoss web but have an existing theme for the rest of their business, and they're hesitant to move away from it. Now, this has led to communities being launched on subdomains or even through multi-sites. So at the end of 2024, we began working on BuddyBoss ReadyLaunch, This is a template system that allows BuddyBoss Platform and Platform Pro to be used with any theme. The BuddyBoss pages will simply render our page templates, while the rest of your site will use your own theme. And as you can see, we dramatically improve the styling of these pages on ReadyLaunch to have a very clean and minimalistic style, which is perfect for customers who wish to use BuddyBoss functionality. Now, more details of the BuddyBoss ReadyLaunch will be available in the next month, where I'll go through the differences between the theme and ReadyLaunch. They are aimed for different types of users, but both of these will continue to be supported and have feature parity. Now, I can't wait for ReadyLaunch, but for now, that is just a glance of what we've got planned, and I don't want to spoil it all, so the rest can be found on our roadmap launching next week. At the beginning of the year, many of you noticed a change in our support system, and this is part of a wider transition, and there are many reasons behind this, but ultimately, the support experiences does evolve over time, and the ticket metrics and results have pushed us to make these changes. We have relaunched our knowledge base and the help center pages to go with it. Very shortly, you're going to actually see BuddyBot, our AI companion, which will help you get your answers quicker than ever before. Even with more than 1500 articles published, we continue to get repeated questions that takes time away from the unique technical issues. So we really want to ensure our knowledge base and our AI companion become that first place to resolve those repeat questions, so that we can react faster and spend time on customers who really need that hands-on assistance. We've also changed our ticket escalation process. And so if you would have noticed a faster response or resolution time, that's because tickets are going to senior support and developers and they're getting involved much sooner than before, giving you a better experience whenever a technical issue rises, in addition to midweek releases for any bug fixes or even manual patches providing hotfixes. And finally, some of you have commented about the lack of live chat support in part of this transition. Now, while this may seem like a step back, the stats don't lie. Less than 4% of our customers found this valuable to them, and the tickets that required our team to log in still needed escalation. So I've taken the decision to remove it, and instead we're going to be focusing our live chat team in a new area. It's far too long overdue, and we are putting those support team members from the live chat and many other members across our team into launching and becoming an active contributor to the official BuddyBoss community. Now, we have huge plans on how this community will serve you, serving as both a resource and a hub for discussion. When launched, our community will house our BuddyBoss Academy, teaching you how to build and configure your BuddyBoss web, app, and third-party plugins. Beyond that, we'll be launching exclusive courses on how to build, launch, and grow thriving online communities with the years of experience that we have within our team. Our customer success team will be hosting webinars and have open office hours. Our support team will be answering questions and sharing feedback. And our community will be a place that you'll be able to see new features, interact with our product team, share feedback, all before it being released into the product. Now, launching a community is just a starting point, but building a thriving community, it takes strategy, focus, vision. And over the last 8 weeks, you may have noticed we've been producing articles and content that helps teach and grow your business. And that's what we aim to share more inside our community. That wraps up our Q1 2025 video update. Thank you for being a part of the BuddyBoss community. Let me know in the comments below what you're most excited about, and I'll be there replying personally. Hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next BuddyBoss update, and hopefully very soon inside the new BuddyBoss community.